Warning, this program may contain visuals that might offend sensitive viewers. Parental guidance is advised.
This is an SABC News presentation.
My name is Ntabi Singh. My name is Ntabi Singh. My name is Ntabi Singh. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. How do I look?
Mama, you look nice.
Racialism is not supposed to be allowed in South Africa.
No,
I don't believe they can live with us.
Our community were surprised to see Ntab saying.
My name is Ntabi Singh, wat beteken blydskap. Ka Sesotho, ke Ntabi Singh, it means hore ko thaba. Ka English, it is happiness. The name Ntabi Singh. Maar my regte naam is Shamaini Bert. Ek het die naam gekry by iemand met wie ek gewerk het. Dit was meneer Alan Cholo, daar by Mandela Park. Hy het vir my die naam gegee omdat ek altyd bly is. En dit maak nie saak wat situasies ek myself bevind het nie. Ek het altyd daar uitgekom met 'n glimlag en blydskap. En soos tyd aangeloop het, dit was my in die begin eers moeilik, maar soos tyd aangaan, dan word jy naderhand gewoond aan so 'n situasie. En ek is bly vir die situasie waarin ek is. Ek is elke dag gelukkig en ek sal so bly en ek sal so wees tot die einde toe.
Yeah, I like to clean in the morning, this morning clothes of mine, because all the time I like to be clean. I don't like it dirty yet. And then in that in Lipalale, close to Botswana, at that farms, we were having a girl doing all this for us all the time.
Yeah, in Katlong, ifundila ama language like Hakitswa Hai, Nagitsi Botswana and Spedi from our mate was working Kamama. And then kena handlana ung hudisitseng ang fundisa di language itseo. So ha kita mo Gauteng,
ke se mona ke sebetsa teng ka ntate Allen Tsholo ke mona ne ke funde o bua seZulu ka le ba ka le di customer ba yenzakala ukuthi ba place i order or ba ukubulisa izinto zinjalo. So I have to take care of it because I was almost like a reception lapha in e ka ka ba Tsholo. And then ni shangani ya Steva ku vulavula na Svenda na Steva Katsongo kodwa.
Katle Home is a location. It's in the township, real township, and in the meaning of Katle Home is Katleho, successful. And this successfulness I see it by myself. Like for instance, these people of Tedco, Bavumi, who's cleaning this whole location, to be nice, to be clean. And then when I started here in Katlehong, it was not like it is now in 2012. That time it was just after what the finished time of apartheid. And then they where I come from, there was black, I mean to say whites, only whites, most of the people. And if you talk to a black guy, you just talk to him, it's maybe the garden boy or the girl, the maid inside the house. So when I came here, I was afraid at all, first of all. And then when I wake up in the morning, there's shacks, there's black people, you can't see a white. And then, like, the black guys, they want to greet you, they don't even know how to greet you. It's good morning in the night and evening in the morning. In the afternoon, it's even in the night time. They want to show they know English, you see? Some things like that, and they say, they call you, they want you, hi, Lina Kyambata, hey, Kyamfuna, Kyamlava. But you just let it pass away, because if you give attention to that situation, you make it worse, you see? So you just ignore this kind of things. But as time goes on, I started to like Katlong. I'm happy here. These people help me. If I need something, I get it. Even it's salt or sugar, milk, you they help you, which white people don't do. They just look at you with an S and pass. But black people, hello, Maki, Dumelang. Nice. If you have a funeral, they all attend. It's nice. This kind of thing. I like it in Katlong. I won't change.
Hello. Hello. The guy. The guy. Papa mogodu eng wa bona ka makala re le go wa le ja dintho tse jwa le mare ya ba motho ra tloela no tshona le motho ona sa tshona le lo ka re ke mo fa tipe le foro ka tla o kena mo kera ere go bele ta fulong go fa tipe le foro are e ma mo ska mpa tipe le foro ke tla ja ka le tso.
I started working in 2006 at 2007 somewhere there at Tedco, where we were cleaning dustbins and whatever dump sites. Then, due to circumstances, I resigned the job. It was fun, and then the people how ikamla utlina ama dustbin kanjan. And this kind of things, there was bad remarks. And then, like, there was this other lady, her name was Pumzile. So Pumzile, she stayed next to our boss of Tedco, Mr. MT. Then she went to Mr. MT and said to Mr. MT, no, how can utato umlungu tina as siswelo musebenzi and ngimayike lwanwa how? So it's there where Mr. MT answered her and said, no, that girl, I saw her working. She's a hard worker. So, and then even though while I was cleaning the dumps, people pass remarks how mlungu cleaning dump kanjan, you see, and then you just ignore these things. Some of when you're not the same all the time, keep on laughing. There's some days when you're on or off, Then you give them an answer back. Ah, for second, Jai, you see these kinds of things. But as time goes on, they accept me and they love me in this community. How Ntabi greet me. So they were getting used to my situation at Tedco. I was having this best friend. She started on the 3rd of March, and me, I started on the 4th. Today we will become very close friends. Her name is Flora Mkabela.
My name is Flora Mkabela. I met in Tabseng on the 4th of March, and I started working on the 3rd. They introduced her to me. Then I showed her how to work. Then we worked together. We became best friends. We liked to laugh. She was a hard worker. So the boss recognized that we are hard workers. Then they took us when there are big events so that we can go and clean them. So the community were surprised because they saw the white woman cleaning the dams, of which people on our community are shy of going out there and clean the dams. So she became a famous. People wanted to know how did she do that. And then Tabseng became famous, and then the people came and gave her some money. Some people wanted to know how did she came here. And then I was the first person to know her secrets or her background.
Melissa, ke ngwana wa ka wa ngwanyana. She's a girl. I was getting Melissa in Natal Spirit Hospital here in Katlehong in 2000. 10 minutes past 10 in the morning. She was about 4.8 kilograms. She was like a big fat thing, just like a. She was like 2 months, 3 months already when I got her. She was big. She was. And then at the age of 1.5 years, Melissa start talking, and she was leaving the napkins because she was bright, she was brilliant.
Kamalabu Melissa, he wrote, the scholars at the Kumalo Primary School, Mufundiso Mistress Mashinini, grade 60, Nyatanda Ukzala, and Chima Ipoxing, Kumkul Mike, and then when I grow up, I want to be a police girl, and who not go by police and whatever. We are was a good when I'm a if Abantu was a chanter, you know how to. We are was a booty, Ufonella Manyama Poisa, as of Neta, Moba, who not go by police, and who not go funda, Moba Abotisha was fully tired, but fully in the right, not in the wrong. Mina no mamam snok sala sitline ndini mangqedile ukuthina ngiyageza ngiyadla mangqeda ukudla mina no mamam snok xoxa but leyo sifikileyo ihlala phakathi kwami no mamam.
Melissa is going to school at Kumalo ubala grade 6 also faile since iliyena net faila. Melissa, she likes playing too much. The house calls, I let her do it at weekend, because during the week when she come from school, she run away. When she finished change her clothes only, she run away, so I must do everything for her. But on weekends, it's her chance. When she's at home, she's helping with washing, cleaning, cooking. This is my daughter, and in Sotho, Kidineo. She's 11 years old. She's getting 12 on the 26th of June. I love her and she makes me happy and she's always smiling. This is a happy girl.
When I was saying la ufike ngabo 26 wafika emncane ehamba umfana wami ne boyfriend yakhe. Umfana wami kwaku umngani we boyfriend yakhe. Ushi boyfriend yakhe isuka from eMaputo. Uthemba Khosa. Bafika la uma befika like us asithengisa utshwala. Kodwa bafika isikhathi uma siqeda sithengisa utshwala washona umama. Uma kushona umama ngesintu uyayeka into eyenzayo uhloniphe, sahloniphe. Sithe sisahloniphile kwafika umuntu Tabiseng ehamba nale boyfriend yakhe nendodana yami.
It started in 1988 when I was in standard 8. I was in Pietersburg Handel School. It was a school for just for girls, an African school. And it's there where I met this guy, John Pollock. Yo, we were very in love with this guy. He's a white guy. And then in the end of 1988, I left school and went to technical college in Pietersburg. Still in love with this guy,
So after time goes on, I finished my N5 national certificate. And then it was the time I felt pregnant in 1991 with my first son. We were still in love with this guy. After my first son, his name is Zandru, this guy started beating me up and starting abusing me. Okay. As time goes on, I fell pregnant again in 1993 with my second son, Desna. So by that time, this guy was still abusing me and beating me up and do funny things to me. It's day where I decided, no, let me take these children to my parents' house. And then I took them there. In 1995, I had enough of this guy always beating me up and whatever. So this day, he was sleeping on the couch. He was out the whole night and the whole day. So when he came back in the early hours of the morning, he sleep. It's day where I decided, no, this is a chance for me. So I went to the safe, open it quietly, take out 1,500 rands. And then, there we were staying, it's on the farms, it's in Lipalale. So it's very quiet. When I run away, I was not having clothes or anything. When I hear a car, I lie down in the grass. And I couldn't see properly because I was having a blue eye. So by the time I came to the main road, far away in the distance, I could see a car is coming. And when it's coming closer and closer to me, it was a red taxi. That taxi is called Zolabat. Okay, I was getting onto that taxi and then I came into town. So this guy said to me, ma'am, I'm going to a tavern for black people. I'm going to have a beer and then after my beer, I'm getting off work now. I said, okay, I'll go with you. When we came there, that tavern, there was a bus, big bus standing outside. It was people from like here from Alberton went to a funeral day in Lipalale. So there was a guy coming up to me, approached me by the name of Moses. And he said to me, don't you want to come with me to Alberton? I said, I don't know where is Alberton, but the farther from here I am, the better. Because even though I should have stayed there, he could have found me that man and killed me or beated me up worse. Okay, that is where I came here to Katlehong with this guy by the name of Moses. Then the following morning when I wake up is day where I start realizing how is life in locationing. It was just mukukus, it was just black people, and it was cold, very, very cold. So I took some of that money of that 1,500 rands and asked this guy to show me where there are shops because I was not having underwear, I was not having proper shoes, all these kinds of things. So, and then I start staying here in Katlehong. That was around about 95, June, July. I was staying in Siluma View, down in the shacks. So then Moses said to me, no, I can't stay there anymore. Then he showed me two other ladies by the name of Nobantu Notkoliswa. So Tkoliswa said to me, no, come and stay with me and my mom. It's better than staying there where you were. Okay. I went staying with Tkoliswa and her mom. Then Tkoliswa showed me there at Mandela Park at Mr. Ncholo's place, where I found the first time a job. And then I started working there in 96. When I started working there in 96, this is where I met Melissa's father, which has passed away already, by the name of Temba. Then I stayed with Temba up until around about 2000, and then I felt pregnant, sorry, in 99. In 2000, I was having Melissa. Then after a while, I think after 3 to 4 years, Temba started his things with other women and do whatever he want. Then here where I'm staying now, I knew this guy from long time, from 98, because they used to buy material there at the hardware, Bongani. Okay, then Bongani said to me, no, let's go and stay together. This is where I started staying in 2005 in this house with Bongani. Okay, in 96, it was still difficult for me to call my parents to tell them where am I, because I'm afraid of this man. He can come and find me wherever I am. And my parents liked this guy and supported him. Also, they supported my children up till today. And then, which they didn't do the same with Melissa. They don't like Melissa at all.
Hello?
Hello, Ma? Okay, hulle gaan nou record and dan moet jy sê, do you agree to record this with me? Yes or no?
Yeah.
All right. En dan, maar die ding wat ek wil vra op die telefoon, ek wil graag hê dat julle vir Melissa moet ontmoet. Stem jy saam of stem jy nie saam nie?
Wat sê jy dan moet sal ontmoet?
Nee, ek meen van gesig tot gesig, nou dat sy groot is.
Ja, sêk maar, hè.
Alright, en dan wil ek graag soen toe kom vir 'n naweek, laat sy met Sandro, hulle kan soos 'n familie, a gathering by mekaar kan uitkom. Ek weet nie hoe voel jy daaroor nie.
Ek weet nie, ek maak nie self hoe ek voel, ek weet nie van Sandro daar omtrent voel, jy weet hoe Sandro.
Ja.
So ek weet nie.
Alright, maar baie dankie vir jou tyd, en dankie dat ek met jou kon gepraat het op die telefoon, ek sê jou vanavond weer bel, hoor.
Okay, so my, okay,
bye-bye. Heard what she said. That she's okay. Ahana butata ka kaya in herself, but my children, and then le abutuaka kase hatsi buruta ekta wato ekta juang, and the kabatsi burba juang pagasi jume. That is the answer. No, she you heard her. She said no. She doesn't feel anything. She don't have a problem, but my sons and my brother. And I know them, and I know how will they respond. And I know how will they respond. I felt otherwise. I felt relieved. I felt more relieved. No, Maki said, but if I wake up in the morning, so today, I go back to a year. I told her, no, Maki, I'm going to go to the house. This thing they do about me, it's about my life. Where do I come from? Banabaka. My family have some battle in Kalabakala. Kidula locationing. Because of the life, no, Jesus, I can't. Thank you.
usathane akusilitho kithi uNkulunkulu Jehova sibonga wena ngokuthi usibeke sase sasa la uNkulunkulu uNkulunkulu asikhali ngokuthi uNkulunkulu usikhalela usathane uNkulunkulu usikhalela ngoba wena uNkulunkulu uyingcwele baba uNkulunkulu Jehova ke komunye ufana nawe uNkulunkulu Jehova ngegama lakho uNkulunkulu ngithi namhlanje uNkulunkulu usichangele sonke.